everyone, it's Nadia from Yarn Utopia. Today we're making this adorable bunny mask. We're going to be making a series of masks, so make sure you check out my website, yarnutopia.com, or my channel here on YouTube for the other mask designs we'll be having on there as well. You know, kids are loving to change their faces in the Snapchat filter, so I thought, why not bring that to life? And we can make different masks and have them play little puppets or dress up or some type of game with these masks. You can tote these for children or even masquerade type or even Halloween. So these are really, really fun to make. So I will list all of the supplies you're going to need in the description of this video and also on my website, yarnutopia.com. But you'll need some Red Heart Super Saver yarn. I'm using four different colors here. There's a soft white, a spring green, a baby pink, and a perfect pink. And then I'm using some felt, some pipe cleaners, and scissors, a yarn needle. We're going to be using a G size hook today, which is 4 millimeters. So make sure you have that. This one specifically is 4.25 millimeters. And this specific hook, I'll put the link in the description where you can get this hook specifically. This is hand-carved wooden handle, so it's a really nice ergonomic style, and I've been having some problems with my hands lately, so these are really nice to use with the ergonomic style. So that's an Etsy shop, Would Be Fancy, and like I said, I'll put the link to get this in the description of this video or in my website somewhere, so you can get the same one. You're also going to need some elastic and a stitch marker, which I'm just using an extra piece of yarn for my stitch marker, just to mark your rounds when you're making the ears. But yeah, and then elastic. So those are all the supplies. Like I said, though, I'll put that in the description of this video. You can find everywhere to follow me in the description of this video as well. Links to my Facebook, Instagram, and everything. So let's just get right into it and get started with this project. So we need to start with the white yarn. Okay. And our G hook. And we are going to start off with a slip knot. So put your short end over your long end, fold this down, and pull this through. And pull tight, there's your slip knot. Insert your hook, and we can begin. So to start off this mask, we need to chain 21. So yarn over and pull through, one. Yarn over and pull through, two. Here's three. 4, 5. I won't make you watch me do 21 chains, so just chain 21 and I'll meet you up for row 1. All right, so once you have 21 chains, this is what it should look like. So that will be, we're starting from the bottom and working our way up the mask, okay? And so now for row 21, we have 21 chains. For row 1, we are going to single crochet in the second chain from the hook and across. So the loop on the hook doesn't count as a chain. So we're gonna start with counting 1 and 2. That's our second chain right here. And what I usually do is turn my chain toward me, and you can see here, there's these back ridges right here. I'm going to be working in those back ridges. So 1, 2, second chain right here. Go in, then yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Okay, that's a single crochet. So now we're just going to single crochet across here. So go into the next chain, then yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Okay, so just single crochet across here. At the end of row 1, you should have 20 single crochets. So I'll just meet you up for row 2. All right, just finishing up row 1 here. Going on to row 2, we are going to chain up 1 and then turn our work around. So now we're looking at it like this. And now we are going to put 2 single crochets in the first stitch. So this very first stitch right here, we're going to make 2 single crochets in there. So go in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2, go back in, and make another single crochet. So there's 2 single crochets in the first stitch, and then we're going to put 1 single crochet in each of the next 7 stitches. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And now each of the next 3 stitches are going to get 2 single crochets each. So go into this next stitch here, put 2 single crochets in this next stitch. So 1 and 2. And then hop into the next stitch and put 2 single crochets in there. And in the next stitch, put 2 single crochets in there. 1 and 2. Now we're going to put 1 single crochet in the next 8 stitches. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So there should be 1 stitch left. We are going to put 2 single crochets in the last stitch. So 1 and 2. Okay, so at the end of row 2, you should have 25 stitches. So now chain up 1, turn your work around. Okay, you can kind of see that it's making that shape where the nose is going to be right there. So it's making kind of that shape. Awesome. Now going on to row 3, we chained up 1, turned our work. We're going to put 2 single crochets in the first stitch. So this stitch right here, we're going to go in, make 2 single crochets. So 1 and 2. And then in the next 11 stitches, we are going to put 1 single crochet. So here's 1, next stitch 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And now in the next stitch, we are going to put 2 single crochets. 1 and 2. Okay, then we're going to put 1 single crochet in the next 11 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. So there should be 1 stitch left. We're going to put 2 single crochets in our last stitch. 1 and 2. Okay, so at the end of row 3, you should have 28 stitches. So now chain up 1, turn your work around. Going on to row 4, we're just going to put 1 single crochet into each stitch across for, again, a total of 28 single crochets. So I'm just going to do that, and then I'll meet you up for row 5. Alright, just finished row 4 here, so this is what your piece should look like right now. So going on to row 5, we are going to, let's see here, chain up 1 and turn our work around. Now this is where we're going to make the eye holes for this mask. So we are going to half double crochet in our first 4 stitches. So yarn over, go into this very first stitch right here. Okay, yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all 3 loops on your hook. Okay, that is a half double crochet. Ooh, well, not like that, but I'll show you again. So we're going to do in the first 4 stitches. So that was 1, so yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all 3 loops on your hook. That's a half double crochet. So that was 2. Next stitch, 3, and the next stitch is 4. Now we're going to chain 9, so yarn over, pull through, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Yarn over, because we're going to make a half double crochet, hold this on your hook like that. And then skip 7 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Go into the next stitch, yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all 3 of the loops. So it's a half double crochet. OK, Okay, so after we skipped those 7 stitches, we need to half double crochet into 6 stitches. So that was 1, yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through all 3 loops. That's 2. Here's 3. And 4. 5. And 6. And then we are going to do the same thing. Chain 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Skip 7 stitches. Yarn over. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Go into the next stitch. There should be 4 stitches left. 1, 2, 3, 4. We're going to half double crochet in each of the last 4 stitches. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Awesome! That was row 5. So you should have 14 half double crochets and 2 chain 9 spaces. So that's where the eye holes are. So now we have to make the top half of our mask. So let's go on to row 6 right away. We're going to chain up 1, turn our work around. We're going back to making single crochets, and we're going to single crochet into each stitch and each chain. So I'll show you how to do that. We're going to go into this first stitch here, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. So there's 1, here's 2, 3, and 4. Okay, now for these chains, you could simply put 9 single crochets into the chain space, but what I'm going to do, and to make these holes, these eye holes a little bit stretchier and bigger, is that I'm going to work in each chain itself. And I like to work in these back ridges. So if you look at your chain like this, you can see the top of the chain, okay? I'm going to turn it back, okay? And it kind of naturally does that, actually. And you can see the back ridges here. So I'm going to go into this back ridge of this next chain here, okay? And then I'm going to single crochet. So yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. Okay, back ridge of this next one. Right there, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. That way around the eye, it will have a nice stitch look, kind of like this bottom half here. There's this nice stitched look along the eye. So that's what I kind of want on the top half as well. So going through this back ridge, yarn over, pull through 2. Okay. And in each chain, I am just going to single crochet, and it's easier to count so you know exactly where your chains are, especially when you're at the first and last chain. It's kind of hard to see exactly where they are. So here's 8, and my last one is right here, and you can see this kind of ridge right here. I'm going to go under that and make my single crochet. Okay. So there's, you can see under here is a nice stitched look. Looks really nice. So now, single crochet in each of these next 6 stitches. And then single crochet in each of chain across the next eye, and then single crochet in the last 4 stitches. So I'm going to do that all the way across, and then I'll meet you up for row 7. Alright, after row 6, this is what your piece should look like. You should have 32 single crochets across. That's 4, 9, 6, 9, and 4. And adding all of those up, it will be 32 stitches. So going on to row 7 here, we're going to chain up 1 and turn our work around. And we're going to single crochet in the first 3 stitches. So go into this first stitch here, yarn over and pull through, yarn over and pull through 2. Okay, single crochet in the next and in the next. And now we're going to make something called a single crochet 2 together, or a single crochet decrease. So we're going to go into this next stitch, yarn over, pull through, go directly into the next stitch, and then yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all three of the loops on your hook. Okay, so we've just basically made two stitches into one. All right, then we're going to single crochet into seven stitches. So one, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. And then we're going to single crochet two together. So let me make sure, yep, single crochet two together. So go into this next stitch, yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through all three, just like that. Then we're going to single crochet into four stitches. One, two, three, and four. And then we're going to single crochet two together. So go into this next stitch, yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through all three loops. And then single crochet into the next seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. And then we're going to single crochet two together. And then we'll have three stitches left. We're going to single crochet in each of those last three stitches. One, two, and three. Awesome, that was row seven. So you should have 28 stitches at the end of row seven. So going on to the next row, row eight, we are going to chain up one and then turn our work around, okay? And we're going to single crochet two together starting. So go into this first stitch, and then yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through all three loops. And we're going to do that again. So single crochet the next two stitches together. Just like that. So there's a single crochet two together two times. Then we're going to single crochet into seven stitches. Just a regular single crochet in the next seven. So one, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. And then we're going to single crochet two together. And then we're going to single crochet in the next three stitches. One, two, and three. Then we're going to single crochet two together. And then we're going to single crochet into six stitches. One, two, three, four, five, and six. You should have four stitches left. One, two, three, four. We're going to single crochet two together. And again, single crochet those last two stitches together. Awesome. That was row eight. So at the end of row eight, you should have 22 stitches. So you can see here, the mask is starting to form. You'll see that it is kind of taking shape, a kind of a round shape for the face. Looks good so far. Awesome. So now going on to rows 9 and 10, we are going to chain up one, turn our work around, and we're just going to single crochet across. So just put one single crochet in each stitch for rows 9 and 10. So I'm just going to do that at the end of row 9. Just chain up one, turn your work around, and single crochet across. When I finish row 10, I will meet you up. We still have to single crochet around this whole piece. All right, I just finished rows 9 and 10 here. So this is what the mask should look like now. So now we're going to single crochet around this whole thing. And when we get to the corners, we're going to skip over the corners. And I'll show you what I mean. So let's chain one and turn our work around. So basically working an 11th row here. We're going to single crochet across this top row. And then I'm just going to single crochet in each stitch across until I get to the other side, basically that looks like a corner. And I'll show you how to get around the corner so that it turns into more of a rounded out corner than a square corner. So I'm just going to single crochet across here and I'll meet you when I get to that point. Alright, so I'm at this point here where this looks like a corner here. I'm going to single crochet into this last stitch, but I'm only going to put that one single crochet. And then we're going to hop down to this row right below here, working on the side here. So I'm turning my work this way. And we're going to go down to this row here and make a single crochet around that stitch. Okay, so that's going to round this corner piece out here. And then we're just going to single crochet along the side of this mask. Wherever your hook fits is where you should just put a single crochet. And it'll probably be in every row. So I'm just going to single crochet down the side here. And then when I get to the bottom, I'm going to also do the same thing. So I'm going to single crochet into this side here. Okay, and then I'm turning this to the bottom, working on my foundation row here. I'm just going to put a single crochet into this corner, but just one, and then hop to the very next stitch here. I'm also going to crochet over this straggler so I don't have to sew that in later. So it's like doing two things at once. Single crocheting across this bottom row, and then sewing in this straggler as we go. So yeah, that's basically it. So we rounded out this corner looking thing here and this corner here. And now I'm just going to single crochet across here and then do the same thing for this corner. And when I get back up to here, I will meet you up and we'll fasten this part off. All right, so I just put a single crochet all the way around here in this corner. You can see I just put that one in the corner and then just went up this side. And again, I just put this single crochet in this side here. I'm not going to put a single crochet in here because you can see that top single crochet is already in there. So I'm just going to go into that top single crochet and yarn over and pull through that loop on my hook. And that is a slip stitch. And then to fasten this off, I'm going to chain one, grab my scissors, and cut this yarn, and then continue to pull it all the way through that chain one, and then pull it tight. And I got to find my yarn needle because we're going to sew in this end immediately. So just yarn your needle. Maybe I grabbed a too small of a needle here. You want a large eye needle. And there we go. You want to go underneath these stitches, actually in the back here. We're going to go in the back and then underneath some stitches, just go underneath them with your yarn needle. Just, I don't know, 5 or 6 stitches. Pull it all the way through. And if you want to fully secure it, you can go back through those same stitches. Just like that. And then cut any extra that you may have. Stretch everything out so that it kind of lays a little flat. Okay, open up those eyes. Awesome. So now we have a cute little mask and we need to embellish it with some bunny accessories. So let's grab our more white yarn here. Let's make the ears. I'm going to set this aside now that we have this finished. I'm just going to set that aside and I'm going to grab my same hook, same yarn. I'm using the same white yarn. We're going to make a slip knot. I showed you how to do that in the beginning of this video, so we're just going to do the same concept. And we're going to start out by chaining 2. So, also in this portion, you're going to need your stitch marker. Where is mine? Right here. I'm just going to use this extra piece of yarn to mark my stitches. But we're going to chain 2, so yarn over and pull through 1 and 2. And then in that second chain from the hook, we're going to put 6 single crochets. So go into that second chain, yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Okay, that's our single crochet here. So again, go back into that same chain, yarn over, pull through, Yarn over, pull through two. That's two. Here's three. Here's four. Five. And six. Awesome. Now I'm going to insert my stitch marker. If you have a legit stitch marker, you want to place it in here just to mark your rounds. So I'm marking the beginning of my round here. If you need to count back six, make sure you have six stitches. Also in this ear, we are going to be working in the back loops only. So I'll show you here. We usually go through both loops like this, both loops, both loops. The loop that's furthest away from you is called the back loop of the stitch. Okay, these are the back loops. So we're going to be working going into here and out there. So that's how our hook is going to go in. And that creates a little ridge here where the front loop is exposed. So you can see the front loop and front loop here. Okay, so we're going to go in with our hook. For round two, we're going to put two single crochets in each stitch around. So go into this first stitch here in the back loop, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through two loops. And then go back into that same stitch for another single crochet. So there's two in there. Go to the next stitch and put two single crochets in there. One and two. And then hop to the next and put two single crochets in there. One and two. Okay, so we're repeating this six times. One and two. One and two. And our last repeat is right here. One and two. So I repeated that six times. One, two, three, four, five, and six. You should have 12 single crochets all the way around. Move that stitch marker up. We're going to go right into round three. We are going to put two single crochets in the first stitch. So right here in the back loop only. Put two single crochets, one and two. And now we're only going to put one single crochet in the next stitch in that back loop. Okay, and then just repeat that sequence around. So put two single crochets in the next stitch, and then one single crochet in the next stitch, and then two single crochets in the next stitch, and then one single crochet in the next. Okay, I'm almost finished here, so you can just continue watching. At the end of round three, you will have 18 single crochets all the way around, and I'm on my last repeat here. So I have 18 single crochets. So now going on to round four, moving the stitch marker up, actually rounds four through 10. So four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, that's seven rounds. We are going to just put one single crochet in each stitch. So just working in a continuous circle, working one single crochet, no more increasing here, till we get to round 10. Once I finish round 10, I am going to, you'll see that this is going to start to bowl up like this, okay? I'm going to meet you up, just put one single crochet in each stitch around for rounds 4 through 10. And when I finish round 10, I'll meet you up because we have to start decreasing at that point. Alright, so I just finished round 10 here. So I did rounds 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 here. And you can see that it did make that bowling shape. And if you flatten this, it's starting to look like an ear. So now going on to round 11. Actually, the rest of these rounds are very similar. We're going to decrease. Let me move my stitch marker up here. All right, so we're going to do a single crochet two together, working in those back loops there. So go into this next stitch, yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all three of those loops. So that's our single crochet decrease. And now we're just going to put one single crochet in the rest of the stitches on this round. So on round 11, we'll have 17 single crochets. Alright, so I'm just going to do that real quick. Here you can see I'm just putting one single crochet in the back loops of the rest of the stitches on this round. And then going on to round 12, we're going to repeat that. So we're going to single crochet two together. Let me get there real quick. There we go. So move the stitch marker up. If you need to, count your stitches. You can count 17 stitches for round 11. So round 12 is the same. We're just going to single crochet two together. And then we're going to put one single crochet in the rest of the stitches around. So for round 12, we're going to have 16 single crochets. So, and then we're just going to repeat that concept for round 13, 14, 15, and 16. And when I finish round 16, I'll have 12 single crochets. All right, I just finished round 16, so I have 12 single crochets all the way around. And you can see here, we just repeated round 11 for each one of these rounds. So each round, round 11 had 17 stitches, round 12 has 16, round 13 has 15 stitches, round 14 has 14 stitches, round 15 has 13 stitches, and round 16 has 12. So now we can fasten this off. So go under both loops of the next stitch and make a slip stitch. So yarn over, pull through and through, and then chain one. And we're going to cut our yarn kind of long for sewing. And then we're going to continue to pull that all the way through and then pull that tight. You can remove your stitch marker and if you need to, rewind this and make one more exactly like this so you have two bunny ears, just like that. So now, once you have both bunny ears finished, we can sew them to our mask. So if you see your mask like this, you can see this shape kind of like this over the nose. That's the bottom. That's the nose section. Also, if you want to see which side is the front, oh my goodness. Well, if you look here, this is the back because right in the center here, you can see this kind of line across here, kind of pronounced. And on this side, you can't. So this side that you can't see it is the front. Also, if you look at the edging of your piece, you can see your stitches are facing you on this side. But if I turn it around, you can't see those facing you on this side. So this is the back and this is the front. Okay, so that's if you want to determine which side is the front, this is the front. And we are going to sew these behind our mask. Grab your pipe cleaners or your fuzzy sticks, and we're going to fold these in half, and then we're going to twist, and we're going to fold them up. Okay, that way nobody's gonna get stabbed in the head or anything. Okay, and then we're going to take this side and shove it inside of the ear. That way these will stand up. Whoopsie, I didn't twist this right. These will stand up and you can bend them or make them however you want then inside, okay? Just like that. So you can bend it and it'll stay, or you can keep them straight. So do that for both of them, and then we're going to sew these on the back side behind the mask. So right about here, if you want to, you can flip this around. Get your yarn needle and take that straggler that we had cut and yarn your needle with that. Again, I still didn't get my other needle. I need a bigger eye needle. There we go. And then we're going to just sew this onto our mask at the top here. So we're going to go in through this row. Okay, and then come out, oopsie. Don't get it all tangled, there we go. Go in and then come back through, but go through two stitches on here. So both layers, okay, because we wanna also sew this closed as well because that pipe cleaner, or that fuzzy stick is inside of this ear. So we want to make sure we sew that closed as well. So you can see I'm going back and forth through the mask and through both stitches of the ear, just straight across. Okay, and once I get finished, I'll show you how to fasten this off, and then I'll let you do the other one on your own here. Alright, so to fasten this off, we are going to go around like that. Keep our finger in the loop. Okay, then come back through that loop. And then remove our finger and then pull tight. Okay, and you can do that once or twice. And then to get rid of this straggler here, we're gonna sew it into the inside of this ear. All right, and then we're gonna cut all the extra yarn and toss that. And there's your ear. Awesome. So now we just need to do the same exact thing for the other ear. Just bend your stick, put it inside, and then sew that ear onto the mask, exactly how we did the other one. So do that, and then I'll meet you up when both ears are attached. All right, I have both of my ears sewn on here. So this is what the backside looks like, and this is what the front looks like. So now, grab some felt. We are going to cut a little piece here to go inside of the ears. So I'm grabbing this felt here. I'm just going to cut a shape that's going to go in the inside of the ears. You can see I folded that in half, so I make two identical little pieces here. And I'm just making kind of like a mini ear insert. Okay, just like that. And now we have two. I'll probably go like that. Make sure they look good on the ears. Awesome. So now grab that tacky glue and let's glue these down. Come on. Okay, you don't need a whole lot, and then just plop it right on there. That way, while we're doing the rest of this pattern, those can dry. Okay. There we go. Ooh, can get a little messy. There. Awesome. So let that dry, and grab your light pink yarn and the same G hook. I'm going to set this aside and let that dry. So I have my light pink yarn. We're going to make the nose next. So let me grab my pattern here. Okay, let's start out with a slip knot. So put your short end over that long end, fold that down, and pull that through. Pull it tight. Set all this aside. Okay, insert your hook. And for the nose, we are going to chain three. So yarn over, pull through. One, two, and three. And in the third chain from the hook, or this very first one we made way over here, we're going to put a series of stitches, actually. We're going to put a double crochet. So yarn over, go in to that first chain way over here, yarn over, pull through, yarn over and pull through two loops, and then yarn over and pull through those other two loops. Okay, that's a double crochet. So you have to make another one of those. So yarn over, go back into that same chain, yarn over and pull through, yarn over and pull through two loops, and then yarn over and pull through those last two loops. Okay, so we have two double crochets. Then we want to make two half double crochets. So yarn over, go in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over and pull through all three of the loops. So another one, yarn over, go back in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through all three. We want to make another double crochet. So yarn over, go back in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two of those loops. And then yarn over and pull through those other two loops. And now we want to make two more half double crochets. You can see I'm turning my work like this around. I'm working around in a circular form. So we're putting two more half double crochets in here and then two more double crochets in there as well. So one and two. And then after that last double crochet, we are going to chain two, one and two, and also slip stitch back into that center. So yarn over, pull through, and pull through. And then we can fasten off, so chain one. Okay, we can cut this yarn a little bit longer for sewing, and then pull that all the way through that chain one, and then pull it really tight, just like that. But now you can see it looks like a mini heart, which is really cute, but I have a little bit of a hole in the center here. So if you started with a magic ring on this, you wouldn't have that hole, but I do because I chained in the beginning here. So what I'm going to do is take my yarn needle with that middle straggler, okay, and I'm going to yarn my needle with that, and then I'm going to go around underneath these stitches at the base of those stitches, and I'm going to sew this in. And as I'm sewing it in, I'm going to pull tight, and you'll see that the center circle, the center hole, is closing very nicely. Okay, then you can kind of stretch this out, make it look pretty, and cut this extra yarn. Okay, flip it to the front. Awesome. So there's the nose. So we're going to take this straggler and sew it onto the mask. So grab the mask, and if you want to make it more of like a heart shape, there we go. So we're just going to go right in the center here, and then take that yarn needle and sew this on very similarly like we sewed on the ears. We're just going to go back and forth. So I'm just going to go through the stitch here and then come back through and go through the stitches on the nose. Okay, I'm just going to go back and forth sewing this on. So I'm just going to do that and then I'll meet you up when I'm about to fasten off. Alright, so I just sewed this on. I just want to fasten off. So you want to end on the inside of your mask. And we're going to go in underneath a couple of stitches. Okay, keep that loop on your finger. And then come back through that loop and tie off a knot. Okay, and you can do that once or twice. And then, let me do it one more time here just for peace of mind here. I'm going to do it once more. Okay, then we want to just go underneath between the nose and the mask. There's a little bit of space here. I'm just going to sew in this end just behind this here. Okay, and then once that's all sewn in, we can cut that and we have our nose on there. Awesome. Now we just want to add a cute little flower and we'll be finishing this cute little mask. So grab some of the perfect pink. Let's set this aside. They're still wet a little bit. So let's keep those drying and grab the perfect pink. We're going to make a flower. So let's make a slip knot. Grab your hook, insert that. And now for the flower, we're going to chain two. So yarn over, pull through one and two. And in that second chain from the hook here, we're going to put five single crochets. So go in, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through two loops. So again, go in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two. So that's two. Here's three, four, and five. And now we're going to slip stitch to the first single crochet. So if you need to, count back five, not this chain here. This is not a stitch. So go into this stitch right here, which is where our first single crochet is, right there. Yarn over, pull through, and pull through. Awesome. So we have five single crochets on round one. Now round two is very simple. We're going to chain three, one, two and three, and then slip stitch into the very next stitch. So go into here, yarn over, pull through, and pull through. And then chain three, one, two, and three, and slip stitch into the next stitch. Okay, and we're gonna do that all the way around, and we're going to have five chain three spaces. So one, two, three, slip stitch into the next, chain three, one, two, three, slip stitch into the next, and the last one is here. Chain three, one, two, three, and slip stitch into the last. Okay, then round three, let me get this slip stitch done, there we go. We're gonna slip stitch into this chain three space, so go in, yarn over, pull through, and chain up one. And in this space now, we are going to put a series of stitches. We're gonna put a single crochet, then three half double crochets, one, two, and three, and then another single crochet in there. And there's our petal of our flower. So we're gonna do that in each chain space. So go into the next chain space, single crochet, then put three half double crochets, one, two, three, and then another single crochet. All right, so just do those series in each chain three space, and then I'll meet you up when we're about to fasten off. All right, when you finish all your petals, just be sure to slip stitch to the first single crochet right here on the first petal. Just slip stitch just like that, and then we can fasten off. So chain one, and then cut your yarn kind of long for sewing, and pull that all the way through and pull it tight. So there's your cute little flower. And if you want to, you can glue a little button in there or sew a little button or something on there. But now I'm gonna set this aside. We want to make the leaves first before we sew anything on. So I'm gonna set this aside, and I'm gonna grab my spring green yarn, and we're going to make a slip knot again. Okay, insert your hook. And for the leaves, they're very simple. We are going to chain six. So yarn over and pull through. One, two, three, four, five, and six. And in the second chain from the hook, we are going to slip stitch. So turn the chain toward you though. We want to work in the back ridges only because we're going to be working on the opposite side of our foundation as well. So turn this toward you. You can see the back ridges here in that second chain right here. So count one and two right in there. Go in to that chain, yarn over and pull through, and pull through. That's our slip stitch. Then in the next chain, we're going to single crochet. So go in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over and pull through two. In the next stitch, we're going to half double crochet. So yarn over, go in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through all three loops. Then in the next stitch, we're going to single crochet again. And in the last stitch, or in the last chain here, we're going to slip stitch. So go in, yarn over, pull through, and through. Now we want to chain two, one and two, and put a slip stitch back into, slip stitch back into this same chain right here. Okay, you can see I'm kind of turning this around now. We're gonna work on this side. And I'm gonna work over the top of my straggler here, this loose end. So yarn over and pull through, and pull through. In this next stitch right here, we're going to single crochet. So go in, you can see it, there we go. Go in, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through two. Half double crochet into the next stitch right here. Okay, and then single crochet into the next stitch. You can see I'm working over that loose end so I don't have to sew that in later. And the last stitch right here, we're gonna slip stitch. So go in, yarn over, pull through, and pull through. And then we're going to fasten this off. So chain one, cut your yarn kind of long for sewing and pull that all the way through and pull it tight. And the straggler that we crocheted over the top is safe to cut as well. Just be careful with your scissors. There we go. Okay, so there's a leaf. So now if you need to rewind this, make one more leaf exactly like this. So you have two leaves and you have your flower. So this is how we're gonna kinda sew this onto our bunny. So what we're going to do is grab our mask. Okay, decide which ear you want to put it under, either this one or this one. Doesn't matter, I'm gonna put it on this one here. Grab your yarn needle and your materials. We're gonna sew these on basically, well, exactly like we sewed on the nose. Okay, so it's very simple. I won't make you watch me do the whole thing. We're just going to sew on the leaves first, so kind of position that where you want it. Go in. And then come back through. Ouch. Okay, and I'm gonna do a little bit of a faster job. Just take your time if you want to, you know, make sure that your leaf is exactly where you want it to be. But I'm just gonna do this, and then I'm going to, you can kind of see here, I'm gonna put this one right here. I'm gonna sew that one on, and then, let me get this through, I'm gonna sew on the flower right there. Okay, so right above this eye. So I'm gonna do that, sew everything on, and once I have that all sewn on, we can add the elastic to use this mask, and then we'll be done. All right, so I just finished making the flower and the leaves on there, sewing those on, and it looks like these are probably dry now. So there's your mask. Now we just have to grab some elastic here and sew that onto here. So let's flip this over. And you want to measure half of the circumference of your head size in elastic. So my head is about 22 inches around. I know, big melon, but we're going to measure then half of that, which is 11 inches. Okay, here, 11 inches. And I'm going to cut my elastic right there. Just like that. Because that will stretch up around the head, okay? And what we're going to do is take our mask here, and we're going to come to this side. You want to take two strands of yarn, just one strand for each side, and we're going to yarn our needle. Oh my goodness. If we can, yarn our needle. I have to get a different needle. You guys, I keep saying that, and I never do. My needle is the worst right now. Okay. We got it. There we go. Yarn that needle. All right. Then go to one side next to the eye. Okay. And we're going to go into the elastic and then into a stitch on the edge here. Okay. Not all the way, just enough. There's a little strand there. Then we're gonna come through the next stitch up here and then through the elastic on this side. There we go. And come through. Okay. Then we're going to tie these in a knot. Just like that, and then yarn our needle with both of those little stragglers. And then sew these in underneath some stitches. Okay, and then just do the same exact thing for the other side. Just make sure not to twist your elastic. We're gonna come to this side straight across, okay? And we're gonna sew that in exactly the same way, taking a strand of yarn and going through, tying a knot, and then weaving in those ends. So once my elastic is attached, we can enjoy this project. All right, there it is. The elastic is on, the ears are dry, everything looks good. So you can, you know, play around with this, use it for Easter or just fun in the yard outside in the springtime. This is really cute, and thank you so much for watching and learning how to make this. You know, if you want to, you can make other masks. Just check out the other videos on my site for the other masks. There's gonna be an owl, a deer, and I think a fox. So make sure you check those out, and make sure you subscribe to my channel. Big thank you goes out to my dad, Fuad Azmat, for taking the time to make this video with us. He is our videographer, editor, and photographer today. So make sure you subscribe, like I said, to our channel on YouTube, and check out all the links in the description of this video for all the supplies and for all the information about this project, sizing, and all that good stuff. So check all of that out at yarnutopia.com. I will see you next time. Happy hooking!